Hi everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a 2011 Beneteau Oceanis 37. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this boat has to offer. Lots of upgrades as we come through the boat, but as we start here at the bow, you can see this large Rockna anchor. It also has a brand new Neal Pryde head sail and mainsail on it as well. And it is really in great condition for its age. As we work our way back, you can see some of the running rigging has been replaced. We have a new Dodger Bimini connector with macrolon on the outside, isinglass on the middle, so that center window will roll up on you. And this is about a $10,000 upgrade that has been recently done. The Bimini itself is quite nice and really allows you to get some shade when you're at the helm, and it also has a overhead window that you can see the mainsail. The 37 possesses a large swim platform here. This is a teak bottom platform. There's our swim step ladder, so it's three steps that kind of fold down into the water, and a really nice seating area that lifts up and gives you access right into the cockpit. But very impressive swim platform for a 37-foot boat. As we come on board the vessel, you can see we have nice wide side decks. We also have this great angled combing with built-in non-skid wood handle. And then again, Genoa tracks here up on the side deck. Coming up to the bow, this is the dinghy with cover on it. But we have a large anchor locker here. This is a electric quick windlass. The windlass itself is quite nice. And then it also, they have it lashed down, but they also have accessibility up here for the winch remote switch and good ground tackle on this as well. Pro furl furling system on it. And as I mentioned, a lot of the running rigging has been upgraded as well too over time. Working our way back, again, all of the sheets and halyards, they're all in a really nice, tidy position, leading to the cockpit itself and making this boat very easy to single hand. And one thing that the Oceanis has done is create this incredibly large cockpit. So even though it's a 37-foot vessel, you have a cockpit of most, 40-foot boats. These are also brand new cockpit cushions that are here, a large center cockpit table. We have two cup holders here. This opens up, so it's a little ice box here. This is a little inlet for a lamp, so desired. And then again, look at these really nice cushions, great material that was used. And then this is really impressive. This opens up, as I mentioned, giving you great access, wide access onto that swim platform, hot and cold swim step shower. There's also a courtesy light down there as well too, and lots of storage that just really kind of opens up and lets you utilize, all the space that it has, hidden down below. But good design there. I'll walk through some of the upgraded features, but newer speakers, a newer Yanmar display here, newer electronics. We have the plotter, we have the Raymarine Autopilot and multi-repeater here. And then again, really nice, stainless steel wheel that's been leather wrapped. You have your transmission controls right here. So when you're maneuvering the vessel, if you're backing it up, you can, face aft and be able to operate your controls. So I find that to be a nice feature. A little traveler up above the companionway hatch. The companionway hatch door is quite nice because it pulls out and then slides down into place. So you don't have, any hatch boards to deal with. And again, it's just a really nice, clean system there. As we come down below the vessel, there are going to be four gradual steps, and it leads us into the galley off to the port side. The galley itself has a huge countertop space here, double stainless steel sinks. There is a trash compartment down here with additional storage. Then we also have this large capacity refrigerator. And again, the countertop space is pretty impressive. On top of this starboard cutting is a little ice box here, and then double propane stove and oven, and additional little cubby off to the port side of the oven. Lots of cabinetry again throughout. Lots of storage for this. Two opening windows here. One opening window in the salon, and again another one over the head compartment itself. So directly across from us is the head, and we have a electric, you know, quiet flush toilet here. We have the mirrors, the little vanities, sink basin here. This is also doubling as a shower because it has the shower sump down below. We have two almost identical cabins going aft. As we go into this cabin, hanging locker, you know, large berth, and just, again, great amount of space for a 37-foot boat. There are two opening hatches as well, too, and really gives you that ventilation that you need. And then off to the port side, again, it's a little bit bigger here. So the berth itself is quite nice, quite large. And then all the way aft, you actually have an opening hatch back there with the small little storage compartment. Opening hatch here, here, and here. So there are four opening hatches in this aft stateroom. Large hanging locker closet here, just shelving little bench right here, and just a great use of space. Right, as we work our way up forward into the salon, and I have to say, this is a very impressive salon for the size of boat that it is. This is kind of like a, maybe leather. Yeah, definitely feels like leather. Might be ultra leather, but it feels like leather. Upholstery here, this large U-shaped seating off to the port side. You know, additional storage. There is that nice hull port, so you have that visual into the water. Large bench seat off to the starboard side. And then again, what I really like is this table itself has leaves that fold up on both sides, so you can actually accommodate everyone around this table. We have this nice grab handle here integrated in with the compression post. And then looking off at the nav station, additional storage down there, built-in microwave here. We also have our VHF, our ProWatt on-off switch here. This is the this is for the inverter. Then we have the newer upgraded Fusion Bluetooth integrated stereo system, VHF 12-volt and 110 breaker panels there. And as we move again up forward, I also want to point out these nice, you know, custom lights all touch here. So blue ambient lighting with a nice reading light integrated to that. Overhead opening hatch here. The dinghy is stored up on the deck. So, you know, these are covered by the dinghy, but really nice ventilation. And then a very respectable forward V-berth. So a little bench seat here, vanity. There's storage integrated into this. A really nice berth. Typically, again, you would put your head here and your feet down below, but it goes beyond the pillow, so it is quite long in length. I think they're like 7'1" or 7'2" length overall. Behind the door here is a large hanging locker, additional lighting, and as I mentioned earlier, overhead opening hatch. But yeah, beautiful floors. Really has this really nice look to it. Very durable. The woodwork's gorgeous, and it, again, just a big open feel for a 37-foot boat. It's something I would definitely take a serious look at. Engine room access is located just below the steps here, and as you can see, it's nice and clean, very well maintained, dedicated engine battery, Yanmar engine on this, easy access to that water pump as well. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 2011 Beneteau Oceanis 37, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. Thank you again for watching. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.